What's going on, family? I'm Scrap of Boxing. Museum of the Forgotten Fisticuff Series. Late 1970s. 1980s was the time to be a fight fan. Because you were treated to some of the greatest fights, undercards, and main events that you would ever see. You see, I saw my first boxing match. But Alexis Aguayo, when he took on Ernesto Marcel. Oh, what a fight that was. Then I had the pleasure of seeing Alexis Aguayo and Ruben Olivares. That fight took place in 1974. Inglewood, California. Marvelous Marvin Hagler. Turned professional in 1973, along with Larry Holmes. Sugar Ray Leonard, who win the welterweight, junior middleweight, light heavyweight championships. He turned professional in 1977 after winning a 1976 Olympic gold medal, but he would get $40,000 in his first professional fight. Marvin Hagler would earn $50, and he came up the hard way. From Boxton, Massachusetts, originally from Newark, New Jersey. And he was a hell of a fighter. Wilfred Benitez turned professional in 1972. And he would defeat Antonio Cervantes in 1976 for the Junior Welterweight Championship belt. The fight took place in San Juan, Puerto Rico. Oh, you're talking about a 17-year-old young man. Meanwhile, Ray Leonard would fight Pete Renzani, Bruce Curry, and he would make it look so easy. 4 or 5 punch combinations reminded me of a young Sugar Ray Robinson. Thomas the Hitman Hearns, known as the Motor City Cobra. He would lose to Aaron Pryor. But when he turned professional, oh, see, he only had 7 amateur knockouts. But as a professional, he couldn't miss that chin if he tried. Roberto Duran turned professional. 1960s. 1972, New York's Madison Square Garden. He would become the lightweight champion when he would defeat Ken Buchanan. Or Thomas Hearns. I don't know what title he didn't win. But during that time, these men fought one another. I was at the 1984 fight with Marvelous Marvin Hagler to take on some outstanding fighters during his time. Remember when he fought Mustafa Hamshaw, New York's Madison Square Garden? What a third round knockout that was. And Marvin Hagler, unfortunately, be unable to celebrate his belt in a ring. In 1980, when he would take on a fighter by the name of Alan Minter, because they would throw everything but the kitchen sink in that ring. They would call Marvin Hagler slurs and the N-word and everything else in between. Ray Leonard, Thomas Hearns, 1981. Oh. Would you believe members of the Detroit community would sell their houses? They would sell their stocks and bonds and annuities, pension funds. They would put it all up for Thomas the Hitman Hearns, and they would lose everything if they believed that much. And Thomas Hearns. And why not? Here's a man who was knocking out everything walking. You can't find that today. 1985. Marvin Hagler. Thomas the Hitman Hearns. Ah, what a second row view that was. And I was in the aisleway when Marvin Hagler would bounce down the aisle with his hoodie on. You would have law. The theme song, War. And you know he meant business. You don't have fighters like that around today. But just remember, at one time, boxing was at its peak. And the names Sugar Ray Leonard, Marvelous Marvin Hagler, Roberto Duran, Wilfred Benitez, Thomas the Hitman Hearns will be in the fourth one. Oh, Thomas Hearns is in a ring with Iran to play Barkley. What a fight that was, 1989. Or was that 1988? Oh. I was at Atlantic City when he took on Roberto Duran. Roberto Duran would face Iron the Blade Barkley in Atlantic City. Roberto Duran would become the middleweight champion of the world. And Iron Barkley would knock out Thomas Hearns for that middleweight championship strap. These are the memories that I'll always have. Because boxing didn't let me down. Not when you had Marvin Hagler. Marvelous Marvin Hagler. Wilfred Benitez. Sugar Ray Leonard. Thomas. The Motor City Cobra. Hitman Hearns. Oh, what a fighter Marvin Hagler was. We can only reminisce the moments when boxing was boxing. Remember going to some of these fights with British walkers, playboys, sheepskin, gazelles, Kango hats, gold chain. The music back then, you had Run DMC and Curtis Blow, Grandmaster Flash. Oh, what times that was. Scrapbook Boxing, Museum of the Forgotten Fistacuff Series. All great fights and all great fights will never be forgotten on my channel. Shout out to the greats of 1979, 1980, 1981, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89. Oh. Thanks for watching. Peace.